By monitoring individual paddocks over a wide range of farms in Western Australia, the Department of Agriculture and Food WA Profitable Crop and Pasture Sequencing Project is working to determine where and when break crops deliver real benefits. The aim is to help growers make sound crop rotation decisions, resulting in a better return on investment in break crops. Mouldboarding is essentially using a plough to invert the top 30 centimetres or so of soil, and for Dan Michael in Mingenew, it's been a way of tackling yield-constraining low pH levels on his northern Wheatbelt property.
Generally, though, the mouldboarding, next door neighbours have been doing it for a while, so the main issues are non-wetting have been an issue for us, and we've had low pH, and we wanted to control weeds, so it's generally been, if we're having some issues along any of those sort of lines, it's an ongoing process. We're probably doing between 400 to 500 hectares a year, and it just depends on where we are in the rotation and what we're doing, if just to alleviate any of those issues that we've got. The pHs were at tops, they're probably around the fives, but at subs they're probably getting down to the low fours, or even in some of them into the threes. So that's why some of those paddocks were pretty urgently. We have been sticking a bit of lime on over probably the last 3 or 4 years, been a fair bit. So 2 tonnes at a minimum. So the paddocks that have been lime, we'd done 4 tonne before we'd turned it, and then we'll put 2 tonne on the following year, and then probably another 2 tonne in a couple of years' time. Weeds are always an issue. Some of the earlier paddocks that we did, towards our second year we've been mouldboarding, the first ones we did are some paddocks that we did have some problem areas with, mainly radish, but we've generally got some weed base in most paddocks anyway.
Now in year two of his mouldboarding program, Dan says the good results are evident.
Well, it's our second year. Last year we mouldboarded and we didn't have any rain for 6 weeks, so it wasn't ideal, but we ended up still out yielding the similar rotations by 0.5 tonne, so we're fairly happy with that. And this year we haven't obviously harvested it yet, it got a big wind blow and all that sort of stuff, but in the last month it's really starting to pick up, so the proof will be in the end result. And last year's mouldboarded stuff this year was very good establishment, like wet, so we've seemed to have alleviated our non-wetting issues a lot better anyway, so it's not seemed to be an issue. The weeds in there is not, the numbers are right down and that sort of stuff, so then it's just the continuing of trying to use all the other processes that we have. The paddocks that we have done, they weren't not productive, but it is, it was just about trying to just manage some issues that we had in there, so that's the main reason why really we're doing it. It's just improving its productivity a bit, yeah.